Marcus fucking Hobson, my guy, what up? Don't mean to intervene. How are things going? Talk to me. How you living, G? You look so confused right now. Do you remember me? Cause I've been with you since a teen, fucking you up mentally. I love it, dude. Staying inside your head with a rent is free. I'm just here to make sure you keep all your crazy tendencies. Look at yourself in disbelief, struggle with your identity. Stuck in depression until you diagnosed with it clinically. How's your love life? It's still a trifling mess. Nigga, you 35, you haven't found a wifey yet? I mean, if I was you, would I be stressed? Y-E-S. I guess a mail order bride is nice, it might be best. So how did you manage to get rich yet be so empty? Constantly stuck in a deep old frenzy. Maybe your ego ain't eco-friendly. Bro, you got a life that we don't envy. And I bet suicide must be so tempting. Do it.
Wait, hold up.
Damn.
Fuck's wrong with me? I can't leave me alone with me. I'm like, who is this nigga? Why do I feel it? Inside the mirror. Wait, hold up.
Shit,
it's got control of me. I don't know who I'm supposed to be. I'm like, who is this nigga? And why do I feel it? And could it be clear? The man inside the mirror.
So how's the rap life? Do people enjoy your music? Or are you still spitting that bullshit to destroy the youth with? Be honest, you live in the shadow with Joyner and Lucas.
Uh-oh.
Jealous? I know that you are, my point is proven. What fuck happened to you? You was spitting so cold. You was the ill minor Hobson on the list with the ghosts. Then you fell off, you should've took a different approach.
Aww.
I hate to say it, but you'll never be like Kendrick or Cole, nigga.
Damn.
It's fucked up. That isn't fair, Marcus. I'm hoping that God will answer your prayers, Marcus. But even if he does, the chances are rare that you have hands in the air headlining Madison Square Garden.
Sorry.
Nigga, put the mic down, don't you fight this fight. Cause you the corny rapper only weird white kids like. So every time the blogs post you, the comments gon' roast you. I would rather be dead than be caught living in your shoes.
Wait, hold up.
I'm tripping.
Fuck's wrong with me? I can't leave me alone with me. I'm like, who is this nigga? And why do I feel it? And could it be clear? The man inside the mirror. Wait, hold up.
Please stop.
It's got control of me. I don't know who I'm supposed to be. I'm like, who is this nigga? And why do I feel it? And could it be clear? The man inside the mirror.
Right, I got an idea. I'll tell you how it works. It's gonna sound a little outrageous, but hear me out first. Turn your phone off for 2 weeks and start an outburst of worried family members, which leads to a local town search. And when they find you, you dead inside of your crib with a letter that says goodbye to your kid. But you don't get to see them anyway, cause your ex is wild in this shit. So in his little head, it's like you already died. It's a trip. While you reside in heaven or hell, whichever side that it is, your baby mom's a regret the shit she never tried to get fixed. If you're alive, chances are she'll never try to repent. I'm just trying to show you ways to exercise your revenge. All you want is love, right? Well, you gon' have to get some balls. Shoot your fucking brains out until they splat against the walls. I mean, it has to hit the blogs and all your fans to get involved. And you'll be missed, cause people don't know what they have until it's lost. Hug your dad and kiss your mom before this transition is done into the new life. Your current one is trash, it isn't fun. Yeah, everybody got problems and we all fighting this big war. But your problems are different. You got nothing to live for.
Wait, hold up.
Oh no.
Fuck's wrong with me? I can't leave me alone with me. I'm like, who is this nigga? And why do I feel it? And could it be clear? The man inside the mirror. Wait, hold up.
Please stop.
It's got control of me. I don't know who I'm supposed to be. I'm like, who is this nigga? And why do I feel it? And could it be clear?
What I'm thinking, what you're thinking is not the important thing. We are alive right now. That is the important thing. It is important that you focus on this fundamental sense of aliveness within you. And then you will see there is a natural distance between you and your thought process. Once you create a little space between you and your mind, between you and your body, this is the end of suffering. Don't identify any thought as negative, because it's just a thought. Who told you it's negative? It's just a thought. You're making it up, maybe you like it. What's the problem? Did you understand? It's just a thought. It has no power. If you think it's a reality, then it destroys you.